the Robotics Engineering Program.
I wake up every day ready to come to this class. I definitely feel fortunate to be here.
What high school student Isabel feels fortunate about is being part of this robotics engineering class at the Career Technical Education Center in Bakersfield. The state-of-the-art facility, also known as CTEC, offers students hands-on training in nearly 40 career pathways at two career training centers.
The goal of this program is to provide students an opportunity to envision a future that they may not have been able to envision in a traditional classroom trying to learn about something abstractly.
Each day, students from 23 area high schools in Kern County arrive at the CTEC campus to spend 3 hours learning the skills needed in their chosen career path.
You walk into any class and you've got students from all over the community, from all different high schools that they've went to, but they're all here because they have a similar interest in a given career field. And so it really creates this kind of unique environment.
It's unbeatable. I can't imagine a situation where a student would learn robotics engineering solely from a textbook. I think it comes down to students getting their hands on the equipment, manipulating it, and then crawling inside of a platform in a group dynamic.
What happened?
Anyways. I think I over-edited it with a new one that I was...
Start from scratch.
You could walk through this class at any time and see a student programming a robotic arm.
3, 2, 1, go.
Or you might see them programming a humanoid robot to greet you as you come in the door, or maybe to guide somebody. Robots that you would see maybe at Tesla or all the way to SpaceX. And the kids are then fueled by their own creativity.
I like the freedom to be creative. He really just lets us do projects that we want to do. Put our own staple on it, so it's really fun. You'll be seeing me work on the Jenga project. I enjoy troubleshooting because the satisfaction at the end of troubleshooting is really amazing.
I think I have the best job in the world. I walk in every day and I step on into a lab setting with students, and I can see breakthroughs that they're having personally where, you know, it's a big struggle sometimes to get a robot to do what you want.
Oh, why did it do that?
And I'm not gonna hold their hand all the time. Students need to be self-sufficient. They need to find the answers. A big portion of this program is confidence. Are you confident to troubleshoot a problem?
I have learned that I thrive under pressure. That's when I can actually do my best. It's not just about the success, it's what leads up to it. It's the struggle, the obstacles. That's what I fell in love with.
Isabel's plan is to pursue a career in aerospace engineering.
I am fascinated by everything that has to do with spacecraft. I think the future is up there.
At the end of the day, my hope is that students are confident that no matter what comes in industry, no matter what comes in life in the next decade, they can tackle it. And I'm excited to unleash these kids on that workforce because I'm confident that they're going to be able to tackle any problem that comes at them.
On the other end of campus, students in the logistics and distribution program are operating forklifts in a 10,000 square foot warehouse.
They learn about how the supply chain works at a very base stage. So how a product goes from a raw material all the way to the customer. We're able to take what we learn in class and then apply it to the warehouse.
It's awesome, I love it. It's actually a really good class. It's a great experience. I am certified in forklifting and I am certified in a warehouse. So I can fully operate a forklift in any warehouse in California.
So I'm one of their last steps before they enter the real world, and just being able to prepare them for life. I'm teaching them skills that they can take and get a job, and these are good paying jobs right off the bat.
We're gonna be inventorying the items. What's the force?
A majority of my students are at risk or have some type of learning disability. And what's really cool is they come in thinking that they have a learning disability, and then I'm able to show them hands-on ways of learning, and they pick it up better than some of my other students.
Daniel is one of those students. He's among the approximately 120 students at these training centers with a learning disability.
I'm diagnosed with dyslexia, so it's hard for me to get my learning experience. So dyslexia is a learning disability that you have to learn from hands-on. I don't learn from verbal. So I'm a little bit different than other people, and I've always taught myself to do better, to push yourself.
Up here we have safety instructions. We also have safety instructions back here. Yes, sir. Any questions?
No, sir.
All right, good job.
The teacher, Mr. Moretti, he'll push you. He'll definitely push you a lot.
And nice and easy going up.
Then you learn to push yourself way out of your comfort zone. You're going to figure out who the person that you're going to be. And I figured out that the person I'm going to be is a passionate and a hard worker, and I'm willing to do anything.
Students say this is where they have found self-discovery, growth, and a wide array of new career opportunities.
I am Pepper. Welcome to the Robotics Engineering Program.
This school has brought so much to me. I have learned so much about myself. This is where my natural talent is. This is what I love doing, and it's something that's going to stay with me for the rest of my life. And that means everything.
Career technical education helps students be ready for both college and career. Within 2 years, 80% of career tech students are likely to go to college or a post-secondary program. Nearly 95% of those who don't attend college had paying jobs within 2 years. High-risk students are 10 times less likely to drop out in 10th and 11th grade if they enroll in a career technical education program instead of a general program.